Our next question is from student Kirk Charles, and he has quite a story here. Okay, so we know that Peter is very excited about launching his new search engine, bitches. This is true. Searchwithpeter.info is actually launched. I encourage
everyone.
It's
a really cool site.
Yeah, I put a lot of work into it, Web 2.0 and all that. Let us suppose that he is targeting the underserved market of Klingon language web searches. Let us suppose also that he is writing some custom hashing procedure. After 8 months of explosive growth in business, I hope so, Peter finds that he needs to double the number of buckets in his hash table. He also finds that the hash buckets are not utilized evenly since he did not understand the hashing of Klingon very well. Sounds like a hard problem. So, his question is, how can we rehash the index without service interruptions? This is made more difficult by the fact that his user base may get violent if he delays search results. Additionally, the long latency of intergalactic networks means he also needs a careful rollout of the new hash. Which strategy should he, I guess, I, take?
Wow. Well, this is quite a question from Captain Kirk. I'm glad he is hoping for the success of searchwithpeter.info, and thinking about the future is an important thing to do. I think one thing I understand is that the Klingon name servers don't support the .info domain. So I think you're probably safe from the Klingon attack for now. But it's a good question to think about what happens when you have to rehash a table. So we've been talking about the standard way a hash table works. Once the buckets get too full or the load factor is too high, you want to create a new table with more buckets, and you've got to copy all your entries into it. If you're running a big service like searchwithpeter.info, well, you don't want to shut down your service while you do that. That would get people pretty annoyed. And if they're Klingons, you don't want to get them annoyed. So what you could do instead, and there are lots of different things, and I don't know what Google does. I'm sure there are lots of solutions that are possible, and they've figured out something that works well. One thing to do would be to start a new copy. So you keep the search engine going, still responding to queries using the old hash table, but you start a separate process, so running on a separate computer, something that's making a new copy of the hash table with a larger number of buckets. And then when you're done with that, you switch them over and you have the larger table with new buckets going. And other than the switchover, there's no interruption in service when you do that. There's some things that make this hard. You've got to worry about, well, what if a new entry is added to the hash table while you're in the middle of copying it? You could lock it, so make it so you can't add any new entries during that time. That might be a bad thing if it takes a long time to copy. You can maybe add the entry to both hash tables. Every time a new entry is added, you add it both to the original one and the copy as you're developing it. You could save the updates and apply them all later after you finish the copy. So there are lots of tough problems to solve to make this work without interruptions, but it's definitely an important question to think about if you're building searchwithpeter.info and you have a lot of angry Klingons.
I probably should have been taking
depending
notes
on the service. Well, we'll see. Hopefully the Klingons don't know where you live.
We recently reached 50 users on searchwithpeter.info. We had a cake and threw a party.
Cool. Congratulations.
Thank you.
That's great.